Most Bangalore lakes have sewage flowing into them, either directly or through stormwater drains connected to the lake inlets. This could be raw sewage or secondary treated water from a sewage treatment plant. The sewage, as well as treated water, is rich in nutrients such as nitrates and phosphate. This acts as a food for the algae in the lake and causes it to grow excessively. This causes large fluctuations in dissolved oxygen levels by the processes shown, which can stress the aquatic life and cause fish kills. The measurement of nitrates and phosphates gives us an indicator of the state of nutrients in the lake. The chlorophyll A is an indicator for the concentration of algae, and the dissolved oxygen variations tell us whether aquatic life is getting stressed or not. Table 1 shows how the common processes happening in lakes increase or decrease the values of different parameters. Table 2 gives the permissible limits for dissolved oxygen and pH for healthy lakes. There are no permissible limits set for the other parameters as of yet. Figure 1 shows a typical variation of dissolved oxygen during a 24-hour cycle. In this example, dissolved oxygen is going below the permissible limits by early morning. Algae produce oxygen during the day through photosynthesis, but also quickly consume oxygen at night during respiration. Collect your sample from the lake with the provided sample container. Now open your smartphone and launch the FemCollect app. Fill out all the sections of your app. Use the provided syringe to measure out little more than 10 ml of the sample. Attach the syringe filter to the tip of the syringe. And strain out exactly 10 ml of the sample using the provided measuring chamber. Once you have done that, take one vial of phosphate reagent A and add it to the sample. Take the dropper of phosphate reagent B and add 3 drops to the solution. Close the lid of the measuring chamber and shake the solution to help the reaction. Pour the solution into the provided borosil cuvette. Close the lid of the cuvette and place it into the provided pipe. And when you reach the questions for water quality, launch the test for phosphate. Place the pipe and cuvette within the green alignment sticker on the back of your phone. The test will take about 10 minutes to complete. You will hear 6 beeps and a test completion sound once it is over. Accept the result and submit your survey to the server. Take the dropper of pH reagent and add 5 drops to the sample. Close the lid of the measuring chamber and shake it to ensure that the reagent and the sample mix thoroughly. Pour the solution into the provided borosil cuvette. Place the cuvette into the provided pipe. From that page, launch the test for pH. And put your phone face down. Place the pipe and cuvette combination inside the green alignment sticker on the back of your phone. You will get a result within a minute. You will hear 6 beeps and a test completion sound. accept your result, and answer all the remaining questions in the survey. Once you're done, submit the survey to the online database. Add 1 tablet of nitrate reagent A and 1 tablet of nitrate reagent B to the sample. Close the lid of the measuring chamber and shake the solution until the 2 tablets have dissolved completely. This could take up to 2 minutes. Once the 2 tablets have completely dissolved and you can see a change in the color of the sample, pour the resulting solution into the provided Borosil cuvette and close the lid. Place the Borosil cuvette into the provided pipe. And when you reach the page for the water quality questions, launch the test for nitrate. Put your phone face down and place the pipe and cuvette combination within the green alignment sticker on the back of your phone. The test will take about 6 minutes to complete. You will hear 6 beeps and a test completion sound. Accept your result and answer all the remaining questions in the survey. Once you are done, submit your survey to the online database.